Hello everyone, how are you? I hope you all are good. So, today again we are going to read a poem from our English textbook, and the title of the poem is Seen Thing, which is written by Yugir Phil. So, before starting the poem, I will show you a short video by which you all can guess that in this poem what the poet is trying to tell us or what the poem is all about. So, let's start.
I ain't afraid of snakes or toads or bugs or worms or mice and things that others are scared of. I think are awful nice. I am pretty brave, I guess, and yet I have to go to bed. For when I am tucked up warm and snug, and when my prayers are said, Mother tells me happy dreams and takes away the light. And leaves me lying all alone and seeing things at night. Sometimes they're in the corner, sometimes they're by the door. Sometimes they're all a-standing in the middle of the floor. Sometimes they're sitting down, sometimes they're walking around. So softly and so creepy-like, they never make a sound. Sometimes they are as black as ink, and other times they are white, but the color ain't no different when you see things at night.
The title is Seen Things. Okay? I ain't afraid of snakes or toads, or bugs, or worms, or mice, and things that others are scared of, I think are awful nice. I am pretty brave, I guess, and yet I have to go to bed. For when I am tucked up warm and snug, and when my prayers are said, Mother tells me happy dreams and takes away the light and leaves me lying all alone and seeing things at night. Sometimes they are in the corner, sometimes they are by the door, sometimes they are all standing in the middle of the floor. Sometimes they are sitting down, sometimes they are walking around, so softly and so creepy-like, they never make a sound. And sometimes they are as black as ink, and other times they are white, but the color ain't no different when you see things at night. Now, we are going to understand the poem that in this poem, what the poet is trying to tell us. The title of the poem is Seen Thing, and the poet name is Yugir Phil. Right? The theme of the poem is self, family, home, and friends. So let's begin. I ain't afraid of snake or toad or bugs or worm or mice, right? The poet is saying that he is not afraid of snakes or small frogs or ladybugs or creepy things like worm or mice. He is not at all afraid of all these things. He is very brave and things that others are scared of, I think, are awful nice. And the things like these creatures from which others are scared of, from which others are afraid of, which afraid other person, he thinks that these things are pretty nice. These things are very nice. I am pretty brave, I guess, and yet I have to go to bed, for when I am tucked up warm and snug, and when my prayers are said. Further, the poet says ki now he have to go to his bed because it's night and he have to go to sleep. And when he was tucked up, when he was in his bed and when he was warm and comfortable and in his nightwear, he was very, very, very comfortable in his cozy blanket. And when he says his prayers, he do his night prayer, his mother came and mother tell him happy dreams. Mother wish the boy good night, happy dreams, and takes away the light. And the mother switch off the light and go from there. That means in night when he was about to sleep, when he was on his bed, when he was going to sleep and do all his night prayer, then her mother came and wish him happy dreams, and after wishing that, she left the room and also switch off the lights and leaves me lying all alone and seeing things at night. When his mother leaves the room, he is all alone in his room lying on his bed. And now the poet is seeing all those creepy creatures which he is not afraid of, that is snake, toad, mice, worms and bugs, right? Sometimes they are in the corner. Here they are means these small creepy things, creepy creatures. These animals or these small little creature, that is snake, worm, mice, yeah, remember? Yes, so here they are means these creatures. Sometimes they are in the corner. Sometimes these creatures are in the corner of the room. Sometimes they are by the door. And sometimes these creatures are by the door. These creatures are near the door. Sometimes they are all standing in the middle of the floor. And sometimes all these creatures which are standing, which are in the corner of the room, which are in the nearby the door, sometimes they all are standing in the middle of the floor. Sometimes all creature came and stand in the middle of the room, in the middle of the floor. Sometimes they are sitting down. Sometimes this creature is sitting down. Sometimes they are walking around. And sometimes they are walking from here to there. Sometimes they are in the corner. Sometimes they are by the door. Sometimes they are in the middle of the floor. Sometimes they are sitting down. And sometimes they are walking also. So softly and so creepy like, they never make a sound. And they are so silent, they are so they are moving in a way without making a sound that you cannot hear anything, but they are in the room. They are present in the room and they walk so slowly, so politely that you never ever make, that they never ever make a sound. Means that you never hear a sound of them. Like they are in the room. They are present in the room. You will never guess because the room is very silent. They never make a sound. And sometimes they are black as ink. Sometimes these creatures are black in color. They are so black like the ink of a pen. They are very black in color. And other time they are white. Some creatures are white as milk. Sometimes they are very black as ink. Sometimes they are very white as milk. But the color ain't no different when you see things at night. Further, the poet is saying ki it doesn't matter either the creature is black in color or white in color, because the color doesn't make any difference when you see these creatures in night, because in night everything is dark, everything is in dark, everything is in black in color. So it is not visible to us either the creature are black in color or white in color. So student, I hope this poem is clear to you all, and in our next video I will tell you the exercise and the question answer of this poem. Till then, please learn, recite the poem, read the poem and learn the poem. Okay, bye.